Welcome back to EDU in 90. On today's episode, we'll be focusing on unique ways that educators use Google Slides in their classrooms.
That's right. Any educator can tell you the importance of creativity and innovation for engaging students. So we asked you for the best tips and tricks for using Google Slides to transform your lessons. Let's check out a few of our favorites.
Slides are a flexible tool, and Bemmacottier and her students have taken them to the next level by creating stop-motion animations. To do this, they create a series of slides where the items are slightly moved each time in order to show a small animation. After creating their slides, they publish them to the web and adjust the URL delay loop.
Over the course of a unit, you might use several slide presentations with your students. Alice Keeler keeps things orderly with her students by taking advantage of the fact that each slide has a unique URL. This means when she or her students need to reference a certain slide, they can share the link and avoid confusion.
Slides could also be leveraged as a tool for developing newsletters, since the elements of a slide can easily be manipulated and arranged. Jeremy McBrayer does this for his parent newsletter, and you can too. In Slides, choose File, then Page Setup, Custom, and then set the dimensions to 8.5 by 11 for a customizable space that can be easily printed, shared, or embedded.
Allie Schultze and her students use slides for creative projects too. They've recently used Google Slides to create digital storybooks and then use Google Cast for Education, or Chrome extensions, to screencast the slides for a read-aloud activity.
Interactivity is key for engaging students, and Lindsay Shields uses slides as a base for creating interactive lessons. She embeds videos and GIFs, adds in hyperlinks to websites, and more. Her students then answer critical thinking questions on the slides and share them back with her.
That's it for this round of tips. In the comments below, let us know your favorite ways to use Google Slides in the classroom.
Don't forget to subscribe, and we'll see you next time for more EDU in 90.
Be sure to check out our last episode for more Chromebook shortcuts from educators around the world.